All right, so welcome to our Global Leaders Europe region call. So, how's everybody doing?
Good.
So Neela, it looks like you don't have a voice. Glad you can chat in the box there. That's great. Glad you are well. That's good. All right. Well, thanks for joining our call today. Let me start my video here. So,
Looking good, Mark.
so I'm in my office today. As I said, it's cold here in Washington, D.C. this morning. And it's still the morning for Yumiko and I here in the United States. So today we wanted to check in about the Global Leader Advocacy Projects. I know we talked about it a little bit when we were together in Vilnius, and we're just having this updated conversation with everybody in each of the regions. Just to give you a few updates, I was just last week with the Global Leaders Americas group who met in New Mexico here in the United States and was able to be with them. Just about 3 weeks ago, I was in Siem Reap, Cambodia with our Asia Pacific global leaders, which was a great experience. And then just this morning, I was on a call with our Africa global leaders, also talking about advocacy projects. So, and I'm so excited for all of you to meet each other in New Zealand. It's a really amazing group of people. So really looking forward for them to realize how cool you are. Because of course, this region, the Europe region, is the coolest group of global leaders. We know that. So we wanted to just give an update on the timing and the expectations for advocacy projects, what we'll be doing a little bit in New Zealand. And we'll before we end, we'll go through a little bit about what you need to do between now and New Zealand, just with the Global Leaders Program. So that's what we'll cover. So I'll jump in, and Yumiko, you can correct me if I say anything wrong. Okay, so
I definitely will. Hi, everyone. That's usually my job, right, Mark?
yeah, exactly. I need somebody to watch me. So I can just launch into advocacy project updates and information, and then we can, whatever questions and comments, we can share some examples of different projects. And just help you get clear on that. So I'm going to share my screen here so you can see what a couple of the things I'll be sharing. So just to give you first an update on timing. So as you know, our Global Leaders program started back in October with the exciting start in Vilnius, where we were together, and all of the regions have been engaging in their regional calls, in mentoring groups. Some have had more success connecting with their mentoring groups than others. We just recently had a meeting with some of the mentors, just talking about the challenges with logistics and technology. So we're still working through some of that. And I think, everybody, one of the big things right now, as we know, everybody's been engaged in the science of ECD curriculum. So we wanted everybody to have a chance to be engaged with the curriculum and be working with the program before we launched into the advocacy projects. So we're at that point now where we're officially going to be gearing up. I know we talked about this in October, I know many of you have been developing your ideas and plans around this. So what the schedule is for all the global leaders, we're having the same conversation with everybody. I just had it this morning with Africa and in the last few weeks with the Americas and the Asia Pacific group as well. But we had, as you know, our webinar on advocacy in general that Ken Jaffe from ICRI gave at our last global webinar. And so what we'll be doing is after this conversation, we'll be asking all the global leaders to be in conversations and thinking and planning around what your idea is for your advocacy project. And that when we gather in Auckland in New Zealand in May, that you'll bring that idea with you to the forum. And we'll do some work with that together during our global leaders meetings. So you'll have a chance to share with your fellow global leaders, do some brainstorming and work. One of our partners for the Global Leaders Program is Innovation Edge. They do a lot of early childhood kind of innovation incubation, kind of like you know, you see with certain business models. So they do that for early childhood, and they're going to be working with us in Auckland on thinking innovatively. And so we'll do some work with everybody's ideas, some sharing, brainstorming, and for, you know, many of the global leaders, it may be an opportunity just to confirm that they're on the right track, that their plans are going to, you know, really fit what will be both innovative and expansive and be good advocacy. And then there's some global leaders that'll come and you may shift your thinking or idea or may expand it or alter it. So we'll do some work together with all the global leaders in Auckland on advocacy project ideas. And then following Auckland, you'll actually complete your official leadership development plan and in writing, and you'll submit that to Stano by June 15th. So you'll have about a month following Auckland to write down what your plan is. And then you'll submit that to Stano. I know some of you have already been in communication with him about what you're planning. So Stano will officially approve your advocacy project as well as the secretariat. So Yumiko or I will look at it as well. So once you have approval from both your regional coordinator and from the secretariat, then you'll move to implementation. So you'll engage what conversations planning with stakeholders, you know, start working on your steps in your project. And the intention is that that project will take anywhere from 6 to 12 months for most global leaders. And so that you'll actually complete that sometime between January and June of 2018. So when we're together next, our third face-to-face meeting for this region will be at the ISSA conference in Ghent in, what are the dates of that, Stano? October, first week in October, I think. We will, you know, be gathering again. You'll be able to do a report with, you know, do a presentation on what you're working on with your project to the group then. And then once you complete the project, sometime in 2018, you'll submit an official report form, both written and also a video of you talking about your project. And both your final report and your video will be put on the World Forum website to be able to inspire the world of what you took on. So that's a little bit of the time frame of how this is rolling out. Okay, so let me just say, talk a little bit about, we talked a little bit about this in Vilnius, but here's the basic requirements for an advocacy project. So of course it should have a focus on advocacy. You're advocating for young children, birth to eight, you know, can be anywhere in that age range. You want to impact individuals outside your own work and program. So a piece of this has been able for you to expand outward, be able to, you know, not just be, for example, if you work in an early childhood center, you'd want to, you know, it can involve your center, but you'd want to impact more than that. You know, with whatever your work is at whatever level with your NGO, your organization, you're going to want to think more expansively. Now, this is a part of the conversation will be with your sponsors and with your own, you know, your own work, your own organization that you work for. And so, you know, often sponsors will want to see an impact, you know, within the scope of your current work. But you want to, you just want to stretch yourself a little further than that as well. So the project can be located in your community, country, or region. Some of these, you know, may happen at a city level. Some may happen at a country level. It could cross borders, but, you know, it's not that these projects are needing to involve 20 different global countries. It's a global leader advocacy project. You're thinking globally, but you're working in your own community and country primarily. You're going to want to aim to expand the impact and reach while taking your experience and competence to another level. So if this is just something you would do anyway as part of your work and doesn't stretch you, then it's probably not at the level you want to think it. So this should, you know, help you stretch into connecting with different people in a different way than you normally have in your day-to-day work. So it's an opportunity for you to expand your impact and your capacity. You want to consider long-term impact and sustainability. So it doesn't necessarily mean you need to start a new NGO that's going to be around for the next 50 years. But you want to think of, you know, how can your impact be more than just a one-off kind of a one-time thing. For example, some of our alumni global leaders from Fiji, their project was to raise awareness of the critical nature of early childhood in their community. And so part of their project was they, in this annual event that happens, they had a booth to be able to educate parents on the importance of the early years. And they had a float in the parade, and they were actually in the float, and they passed out their early childhood campaign materials. And so that was part of, it was successful. It was part of their project. It raised awareness. But it's interesting because I was just talking with Anna Lacey, who is the one who did that project. She was with us in Cambodia at the RNEC meeting where we had the global leaders. And that event has had the same focus on early childhood every year since then. So now it's been several years. There's still a booth, and I think they still do a float. So it's become part of a tradition in the community that continues to focus. So not all projects can live for years, but you know, you want to think of, you know, how can you expand the scope and impact of working? As I mentioned, project timelines are 6 to 12 months. And the other thing, global leaders can partner on projects. So we've probably had maybe half of the global leader projects in the past that have had, you know, more than one global leader that partners together. This typically has happened more when you have more than one global leader from the same country. We had, for example, our two global leaders from Zimbabwe are talking about partnering. But it's fine to do it just on your own. For example, we have two global leaders from Australia who are likely going to do their project separately in their own communities. So it's but that's an option for you. When I did my global leader project, when I was a global leader, I partnered on that with another global leader, and we so that was a helpful thing. So that's an option for you. Okay, so let me just share with you one more thing. I think we may have handed this out when we were together before. This is going to change just a little bit, but we'll be sending out to you the advocacy project plan that you'll actually fill in. So after our meetings in New Zealand, there'll be an actual plan that you'll fill out that'll have the project description and title, outcomes you anticipate, who your audience is, methods and approach, the timeline, and what's your how you plan on spending your funds. Because as part of your sponsorship, every global leader has $1,000 US for seed money to support your project. Now you may seek funding or volunteer or other resources from other stakeholders or in addition to that, but you will have $1,000 to use for your project. Okay, so this is what you'll fill out and submit to Stano by June 15th. Okay. And then in when you come, you know, at the end of our Global Leaders program, you'll submit a succinct like 2-page report that'll have your picture and name with a project description and your project results and impact. So we'll give you these forms and that'll be part of it, because we want this, you know, part of this is an effort for you to grow as a leader and an advocate. And another part of it is to be an incubator for ideas in terms of, you know, what people are trying and working. You know, and from my own experience as a global leader and from seeing others take on projects, it evolves over time. There may be results you anticipate or activities you plan when you create your plan for your project that may never happen. And there may be things that you didn't anticipate results or activities that end up happening. You know, when you start engaging stakeholders and others in your community and colleagues around things, sometimes projects evolve and there are things inevitably that you're disappointed that you didn't achieve and other things that, you know, you're surprised you're able to do. So that's just the nature of how it unfolds over time. Okay, so I'm gonna stop sharing the screen here. All right, so that's just a basic kind of overview of expectations and the time frame and how it will work. So what questions, comments do you have just about that?
Can I go first?
Absolutely.
So my mic is working, yeah?
I hear you loud and clear, Sinisha.
Okay. So at the first, when I was thinking about the project, because there is some initiatives in Croatia, I already contact RAIN and ISS, Croatian ISS. So we discussed and they told me like that they want to gather the data and publish the data. But over the time, I thought I do not want to do that. But there is now, in the moment, advocacy platform. It is run by Association OASA from Rijeka in Croatia, but is also supported from some Roma association, UNICEF, Ombudsman for Children, and so on. And the goal of advocacy is to ensure harmonizing the rule book for the preschool and the national platform for Roma inclusion. Actually, what they want is that they want to make obligatory 2 years of the preschool education in Croatia. And I think that this kind of thing is very good. I think that is sustainable, because if it's the law, then it's going to be permanent. And I would like to do that. But the thing is that this advocacy platform is already started. Mm-hmm. And I would like to support them and to be included, but I should be included now. Wait for, I don't know, these 3 months. Mm-hmm. And why I'm asking that, because Roma Education Fund is financing this association or ASA, and they have some money for their work, but they are working with the children. This advocacy thing just became like, they saw the need in Rijeka, and then it became national. And they do not have the money for this meeting. So often they are asking for some venue, and last time they didn't get any venue. So from this seed money, I could rent a venue, for example. Mm-hmm. And also I can also be included in writing the letters. They already wrote some letters to the Ministry of Education, yeah. But I have the connection because I know the deputy minister. So I already told him about that, but they are still like, do not want to do anything because it costs money, of course. If it's obligatory, then it's going to be doubled, because now we only have 1 year of the preschool education is obligatory, and it is 250 hours per child, the maximum, but it can be less. So, you know. So what about this? Can it be done earlier, or we need to wait after the
New Zealand? How exciting. So that sounds great. So, you know, and this, I think that's fine. You know, I think there's, our general rule is that until the official project's approved through our process, mm-hmm. that we don't have people spend any of their advocacy money yet. However, I know that, you know, we've been in these conversations since October, and you're already likely engaging with others around possibilities and plans, and that's wonderful. So we don't want to slow that down. I think we do want to, while we're in Auckland, be able to work on advocacy project ideas and plans so that you may expand or strengthen what you're already doing. So, you know, if any of you have a special circumstance like that where you would, you know, particularly there's a need for your advocacy funds before June to move ahead, then I mean, we can expedite that. So I would just be in communication with Dano. And if you want to, you know, submit your tentative plan and be working on it, you know, we can work on that. We just wanted to give everybody a chance to really engage in the curriculum and in our Auckland meeting, because it may strengthen what you're doing or elements of what you're doing. But I think that's great, Sinisha.
Super. Thank you, Mark.
So, Stano, does that sound okay to you? I think if you guys just talk about that, I mean, it seems like
Stano can only write. his mic is not working.
Stano, why don't you sing something? Let's see if we hear it. You just don't want to sing. That's what it is.
He's standing on the...
Nice. I did not intentionally silence you, Stano. So if you're wondering if there was some foul play with your microphone, that's not me. So, yeah. So, Sinisha's not... I think if you just work through... Yeah, just be in communication. It sounds like a great... So we don't want to slow anything up. We just wanted to give you full access to all of the, you know, all of the resources to be able to help you with that. So,
thank you.
So I just tried to unmute you from my end, and it says you're unmuted. So, okay. Any other questions? Brigitte, did you raise your hand? Is that actually a hand raised there that I see next to you? Brigitte, if you're talking, we can't hear you. Yeah, can't hear you, Brigitte. If you want to type in the chat box, if you have something to ask, that's great. While Brigitte's doing that, any other questions, comments, anything to ask?
I have a question, if I might ask.
Yeah, Brigitte, go ahead.
First of all, hello, everyone. It's good to hear you all. Okay, so in your presentation, you said that the project should be lasting 6 to 12 months.
Yes.
What if it lasts, let's say, 5 months? I don't know if it's going to last exactly 5 months, but I'm just interested to know if that is possible or it just has to be 6 months to 12.
No, it's flexible.
Okay. Another question I have, could you please clarify better?
Because if you can, Vritin, if you can change your country's policy on early childhood in 3 months, I mean, that would be great.
So. Okay.
Yeah. So you can do it faster.
Okay. My second question was, there was a line in your presentation saying outside our work, we should try to impact those that are outside our work, individuals that are outside our work. What did you mean by that?
So what you want to do is think of the most impact you can have in the amount of time you're doing this. So for example, when I did my global leader project, when I was a global leader, in the network that I work with and in my work, there were early childhood centers in various parts of the United States and Puerto Rico that I was already working with. And so I could have just focused on just working with those programs that I was already involved with. But I decided to add a community element, so involving those centers in their communities with other stakeholders and with the municipality. So you want to have this be something you're expanding your reach and your context. Now, what that looks like for you, I know some of us already have more expansive work than others. You know, some of our global leaders work with NGOs that are already working at the national level. So, you know, having scope within that already works. Some global leaders may just be working, you know, for example, Shabreen, who's one of our global leaders from Fiji, she owns her own early childhood school. So, you know, we wouldn't want Shabreen just to do a project at her school. We'd want to involve the community. So that's the intention.
I understand. Okay. And so you also said that originally it is planned that once we are decided upon the project that we will receive the grant at the end of June, right?
Yeah, or whenever you need to spend those funds. That's flexible, the timing.
Okay. So that means that we can already start working on it, right?
Yeah. So, you know, I think we want, you know, for your official approved project, you know, there's certain criteria that we want all global leaders to engage with. And so that's the approval process. It's getting a chance for Stano to,
of course,
give his blessing, and for Yumiko or I, one of us, to look at it from the secretariat. And, but, you know, once you start talking to people about your project, you're actually starting the project. You know, so to talk to your own organization, to other people, I mean, that's starting that process of advocacy. So many of you, I'm sure, have already been engaged in that. So it's not meant to slow that down. we just, you know, for your official approval and for the funds to be released, there's that process we want to do. And as I mentioned with Sunisha Sinod, you know, if there's something you need to do sooner than that, and you have, you know, I mean, it can be a conversation.
Okay, so the procedure is also going to go through our organization, not through us individually, right?
That probably, but it can be a conversation. I mean, so depending on what you're using the funds for, you know, that's part of your budget and your plan, and we can figure out what makes the most sense.
Yeah, I understand. Okay. Well, I just, I have already two ideas that I'm thinking about, and then we'll see later. I don't want to take more of your time, but thanks for answering the question.
I'm sure both ideas are amazing, just knowing you.
Yeah, you're very good at encouraging. Thank you.
Yeah, and if you're only doing it in 5 months, maybe you could do both ideas. One is 5 months, the other is 5 months, and then you do two.
Well, I'll just say this shortly. One is a short documentary that will follow a Roma 5-year-old that is just, let's say, normal as everyone else, and we could just follow her life, her fears, her messages she has to send for the world, and things like this, just so you know. We have also Roma children who are not always being talked about as being always vulnerable and things like this. And another idea that I was thinking about is a bit bigger, but I like it, I think, more, is setting up studying and playing corners inside houses of the Roma communities. So we will see. I don't know. But yeah, we will talk a bit, and I'm sure you guys will help me.
You know, one of the, we had global leaders from Brazil in the last cohort that did public service announcements. So they it was mostly on radio. They had some videos too, but they, you know, they shared to raise awareness in the community. And, you know, if you're thinking about video and documentary, one of the people we can connect you with at the World Forum is Isabella, is our global leader from Brazil, in this cohort with you. Mm-hmm. She works for a foundation in Brazil that does a lot of publicity and video and things in terms of promotion. And she might have she's really done a lot of work with that. And so if you're looking at doing a documentary and how you get that out there and promote it, she would be a good resource as well. Well, there's
okay.
lots of folks that can give you ideas on how to deepen and expand the reach of what you do. Like, that's great.
Okay, thanks a lot.
You're welcome. Okay, anything else?
I raised the hand. Can I go again?
Yeah, great.
Okay. Actually, it was the same question like Dritten has. It was about, can we do two projects? And yeah, this is the answer that we can. And actually, I was also wondering how the funds will come to us, because now I do not have association. Because I was a president of Roma Youth Association, but now I'm 35 years old, so I'm not anymore young. So I do not have association anymore. That it could be good that it's also flexible, you know.
Meant to be flexible. Did that answer your question, Sunisha?
No. The question was just to confirm that it can be like funds can be could be transferred to us on our personal account, not on the.
I think so.
Yeah.
Okay. So there's and we can talk with Roger just about what that would look like, and so. You know, when you're thinking, when part of your plan that you'll fill out is what your budget is and the kinds of expenses you want. And so based on what we look at for those expenses, you know, what kinds of things you're using it for, then that's, yeah, we can work that out.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Other questions? Okay, I think when we were together, we'd shared some samples, examples of what global leaders have done in the past. You know, there's been all sorts of projects. We've had people focus on policy advocacy at the national level with the ministries. As I mentioned, in Brazil, there's public service campaign they did. One of our global leaders in United Arab Emirates in the last cohort was focusing on children's health in Abu Dhabi and Dubai, where there's a higher wealth from a lot of the population, but it's an unaddressed issue as a lot of health issues that are young children experiencing. So she partnered with the local law enforcement and some other stakeholders to promote, health. So there's lots of different pieces here, and I think it'll be really interesting, I think, as we come together and you hear ideas of what the other global leaders in their, own countries are thinking about and trying to take on. It may inform, like I said, some elements of your project that, might strengthen it. So there'll be some more idea sharing when we're together in Auckland. So any other questions just about advocacy projects? Any of you have? No.
Hey, this is Stana.
Hey, I can hear you.
Yeah, I've managed to connect through mobile. That's funny. So I just wanted to tell everyone, if you want to talk about your ideas, I'm always available. So just try to reach out to me and I'll be happy to talk to you about the idea before you start to elaborate it more. And also please keep in mind that you can always use the Romani Early Years Network, either the international level or if there is a national network in your country. That wasn't me.
That didn't sound like you, Stano.
Yeah. Yeah, so that was what I wanted to share. Yeah.
Great. Perfect. And Stano is your direct primary point of contact to support your project. So, of course, Yumiko and I from the Secretariat, we're available to support you with ideas and, whatever you need. You also have mentoring groups. Now, I know there's several mentoring groups that have struggled connecting based on time zone or logistics or technology. We just recently had a meeting with mentors to brainstorm that. So, we're still working through that process. It's been a little messy. Anytime you connect people in so many different time zones, it is. But, you have alumni mentors that are assigned to you. You're welcome to pick them for ideas in terms of what they did themselves. Now, Stano's the one that is your direct support and will direct and guide you with your project. The alumni mentors, that's not their role. So, part of your regional calls going forward with this group is to check in on your project. So this is where you have a chance to share ideas regularly when you connect as a region, just around what's working, what you're, taking on with the project. So this, your regional group is the primary place to support you. But you may find, based on the topic you take on, there might be global leaders in other regions that are doing something similar. That's part of the reason we're sharing at Auckland. So, you may have other folks that you share ideas with. They're focused on something similar.
Mark, do you hear me now?
Yes, I do.
Oh, super. Thank you. Okay, I called now the professional, just a second that I close the door, please. Thank you. Okay, super great. I'm so happy. So hello to all. I will, because we are now almost, is it at 5? It was supposed to be finished?
Say that again. What was
Are we limited in time, or I have, I don't know, five
no,
minutes?
No, yeah, absolutely.
Okay, thank you, thank you. Okay, I have concerning maybe all the posts and all the this every 2 weeks what we have to report. And so I'm a little bit in the delay. This I have to excuse myself because I was really a lot of now abroad last month. But concerning this advocacy plan, I have written, Stano sent us one link from Open Society Foundations that for additional grant, I wrote on 5 pages, but I didn't get any response, you know. And this was by the end of January. And I tried and worked really hard, but even not even the negative answer, you know, I was really surprised, but okay, nevertheless. Concerning this advocacy plan, I think I have now finalized what I want to do, if I will get approval, of course, from Steiner and you. And this is basically this. First, I wanted to do something regarding Roma population, but then I, as far as I understood, since I was supposed to do something concerning migrants because of Roger and Bonnie. Yes. Here is something special. So now I decided like this. We have not have problems with, we didn't have problems with the migrants. Maybe some economic migrants, but in this people who were asking asylum seekers, and so we didn't have problems. But now we are facing this really in the huge extent. But we are writing strategies, regulations, all these documents, you know, and papers on another paper and strategy on another strategy. But really, when you talk to the kindergarten teachers, because I will focus on preschool, it is hard for them because we are not, preschool in Slovenia is not obligatory, it's compulsory. And so we don't have any legal, how to say, grounds to give them extra hours, you know. And they are left by themselves, how they want to do, what they want to do, and it's really a huge space for them, you know, how to, I don't know, how to solve this problem. And especially since they are getting more and more children from the regions that they don't even speak few words, you know, of their language. So what I decided now is that, but okay, that I will make a documentary movie, which will involve, if I go step by step, I think it I will need half of the year or 1 year, and it will be focused in first part on the migrant, these houses, you know, how they are dealing that the preschool, how there is, I don't know, how they are touching this subject, who is playing with the children, how, what is the quality there. Then I want to focus mostly, I don't know, 70%, what is the different methodology, how the kindergartens are and the preschool teachers are dealing with this. And the result and the goal of this, I want that even now the state is planning another strategy. It is like another program that will be finished in 2 years. Now it's the pilot version. And after that pilot, we will have 2 year additional time to make some changes and improvements. But it will be another paper that this, no one can understand that these teachers cannot use it. You know, it is something on the paper, but no one is gathering the good practices. They have invented so many good examples when they have a child in front of themselves, how to deal with him. So I want to make like good practices, good examples, also something from Italy and Hungarian, because they are also this bilingual, you know. And So I will focus on this advocacy, on the migrant area. It is, so if I go step by step, here it is children from, it will be from 0 to 6. It will be also impact on the individuals and on the groups. It is located in my community region, but they can use it also abroad, you know. I'm thinking about but I think here, I'm only thinking about this. I know if I want to have the cameraman, if I want to have someone for the sound, if I want then someone for the post-production, for the graphics, I don't know if I will have enough. I don't know where I will get additional 4,000 euros, I think. I don't know, because that's why I was hoping on this Open Society funds, some additional. Okay, I think also long-term impact. I was thinking, and I think that it would be really accepted with welcome, that also when the new program or the strategy, it will be accepted on the state level, there will be needed, they will need something that will be operative, you know, that something they will offer to kindergartens, how you actually on the practical level you do it, how you implement it. And also we have the problem because in our asylum houses and integration houses, the parents from Syria, I don't know, from Afghanistan, whatever, they don't want to send their children to kindergarten, because they think there is only nursery, you know, but it is education and it's also really crucial for the further education. And they maybe have this misunderstanding what it is actually in kindergartens happening. So, okay, to make it short, it is awareness, raising awareness also among these migrant families, parents, raising awareness among majority populations, how hard it is for the migrants, and to 70% to make it easier and to make a proposal and the plan on the operative level for the old teachers and assistants, how they can do it to help each other, because no one else will do it, you know. The ministry will not do it. The kindergartens will not do it to put it all together on the, because they are all, you know, making like everybody is making his separate garden, you know, and I want to combine this everything into one unit. If you understand me, yes, I was clear or not enough?
Yeah.
How do you think? What do you think? The first impression?
Sounds amazing.
Uh-huh, okay. I'm glad to hear. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, I mean, what I hear you talking about, Birgitta, is identifying really emerging needs that are happening,
yes.
You know, finding ways to promote, you know, critical entry points to to access early childhood services. You know, I like that you're already looking for additional funding, you know, from other sources to help strengthen this, you know, and it's one of those things that there's, for some projects, it may be that you're able to accomplish a certain point, you know, certain segment of the need during your global leaders. And then, you know, there may be additional things that you launch off after that. But I sounds pretty exciting to me.
And also we could use it, you know, then afterwards we could use it in the international area, you know, if we would get the subtitles, how we are dealing with this problem. Because yesterday we had the High Commissioner from the Council of Europe for the Human Rights, and they are saying we are searching for the states that were not dealing with this migrant issue before, and because it's hard for them if you don't have the strategies, if you don't have the plan how you will do it. And here we are really the beginners. Slovenia is the beginner. We were not faced with this problem. So I think it's really, I'm really so excited about this. So happy, really.
Yeah.
That also, you know, that you feel that you can move something from the dead point, something to make it easier for many people, you know. So this is this, what I'm thinking. Mm-hmm. Mostly.
That's wonderful.
Okay.
Yeah, and Birgitta, when you're in New Zealand, I think one of the options around additional funding, Joan Lombardi, is the one who, you know, her grant is partially funding your sponsorship, and she, mm-hmm. you know, she's really concerned about the refugee immigrant mm-hmm. issue in mm-hmm. Europe and elsewhere. And she is a really good one to talk about possible funding sources. Mm-hmm. So when you're there, she'll be with us in Auckland. You'll want to ask her about that. She can give you some really great ideas in terms of where to turn to.
Okay, thank you. Thanks a lot.
And we'll be Joan, who is quite a well-known figure in the international early childhood world. She's a senior advisor for Bernard Van Leer, and she, for many years, worked in the United States government on early childhood issues. And mm-hmm. she is the one of the founders of the Global Leaders Program. It was her idea to do Global Leaders. And mm-hmm. she always wants to meet with global leaders. So we'll have some time for those of you from this region to sit down with her for a lunch or some time to,
please.
She always loves to talk, but you know, and Brigitte, you'll want to probably follow that up with her just to have her help you brainstorm around where to seek funding for that.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Thank you for that information. I'm thankful, really. Okay. That's really not so good connection anymore.
I can hear you. But I can hear you only you, nobody else.
Me?
Yeah, Brigitte, you.
Oh, really? But I lost also Mark. I lost now everyone, except you.
Except me. I think that uh-huh. we are only one left now.
I'm here. It looks like Mark got kicked off.
Yes, right? Yumiko.
There.
Yes, Yumiko, what happened? Bad connection or something?
Huh.
Yeah, Mark is no longer with us.
Sorry.
Okay, again. Yes, okay. Welcome again.
Thank you, I'm back. My internet just went out, so.
Okay.
I was just going to say, between now and when you are come to Auckland in May. Mm-hmm. So what everyone will want to do is you'll want to bring your idea for your project so that you can share it. Also, we're asking everyone to complete all the modules of the Science of ECD curriculum. Now, Brigitte, you mentioned, I know there's several global leaders who, you know, based on what's happening with their work or lives, you know, not on time with each module. So, you know, at least complete every module, even if you don't do it on time, before mm-hmm. we come to Auckland. We'll be having a group discussion there just about Science of ECD. And Yumiko, you can correct me if I'm wrong, but what I would recommend, if you've missed some modules, I'd recommend you engage in the one that everybody else is doing right now so that you can be part of the real-time conversation. And then if you need to go back and finish one of the previous ones, do that, you know, when you have time. But it's mm-hmm. there's a lot of value in engaging while everybody's in the conversation. Yumiko, anything else you want to say about Science of ECD?
Nope, that's the same advice I've been giving to others too who've gotten off track or are delayed somewhat. So
yeah, so I just, wherever the group is at, just engage with that module, and if you need to go back and finish that, go ahead and do it. But it's one of the requirements, you know, we want everybody to have full access to that, all the modules, even if there's a few you don't complete on time.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So just make sure you bring your ideas. Now, if, you know, I know we're working through visas and some things like that. Lori Hand from the Secretariat is supporting you. So, you know, keep working on what you need. If there's any issues around that, you can be in communication with Lori and me and Yumiko just around preparing to be there. And, but other than that, we're excited to have you meet your colleagues from around the world. It'll be a great, great week. So Yumiko, Stano, anything else you want to add?
No, not really. I'm looking very much forward to meeting everyone in Auckland and possibly some people already on the flight. I don't know when everyone is flying, but we should make sure that if we are on the same flights, we should at least know about it.
Great. Very good. Well, all right. Thanks, everyone. It's been great to visit with you. Excited to see you soon.
We are also, Mark. Thank you for taking your time and for all the explanations.
Can I speak a little bit more?
Sure, Sinisha.
I'm sorry to, I need to apologize to everyone, but I really need to tell something to Brigitte. Brigitte, is wonderful to listen to you. And you are very, very motivated and enthusiastic. And I think that what you are facing now in Slovenia, that it could be in some way connected to Roma, because it's about bilingual thing. And also, yes, like Roma parents do not want to send their children in the kindergarten. And we also wrote many strategies, but you could use like some things what happened in Croatia regarding Roma and just copy it, but to another group. And the second thing what I wanted to ask and to tell Mark, now you are here, you Minko, you are also here in Stano. I'm also mistracked with mentoring groups and with because I was receiving the emails on Roma Education Fund and everything go to spam, and then people replying on the email, and then you have like 50 emails, and I couldn't even find who is my mentor. And actually I called Božo, but then Božo said that we are in different mentoring groups, because I didn't even understood that we could be in different mentoring groups, even though that we are from the same region. So actually I'm also waiting with that. Actually, only thing what I did was print out the lesson series and read it. And I didn't comment anything, because Božo said to me that they are commenting like every week, one post. I didn't do any of this. And then Yuminko called me once and said that I'm not registered. But I'm registered, but I cannot enter in anything. So I really need in this subject, I need like restart. And if somebody could call, just send me the name or email of my mentor, if it is mentor connected to the things what I need to do and read the models and pass the models, that because I'm losing something which should be for me in this program, and I'm not very happy with this. I'm very happy with what I'm doing, like advocating that I hit the webinars, but I need help now about this mentoring and modules.
Yep, great. I'll send you your mentors, Sinisha, are Kolani from Swaziland and Leonard from Kenya.
Okay.
And I'll send you their emails right now. And just so you know, there's quite a few of the groups that have struggled getting together for technology or time zone reasons. And so you're not the only one, and it's okay. Well, we told them recently, for the groups that haven't been able to connect, keep trying. You know, there may be a few adjustments in mentoring groups if the time zones just really aren't working for certain groups. So it's something we're still working out the kinks. And again, the purpose of the mentoring groups is to make sure that you have a chance for sharing, you know, from folks from other countries. That's why we did it outside of the region, and a chance to just discuss the readings. So I'll send you just right now who your mentors are, the emails, and you can connect with them.
Okay, thank you, Mark, but please send me on my private email, not Roma Education, because everything goes to spam, and then this pen is somebody is emptying it, and then I cannot see any emails. This is how I lost a lot of data. Actually, I lost it and spent a lot of time to track the data. And this is it. Now I'm receiving all on my private emails except this mentoring, because I didn't receive any email about that.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
I'll send it to you right now.
And Sanisha, in terms of the science of early childhood development course, talk to me about that, and I will try to help you. I'm quite familiar with the system, so as soon as you can log in, which I hope somewhere you still have your activation code, then I can guide you through that because. Like, let's benefit from the fact that we are in the same time zone.
Yes, thank you, Stan. Yeah. I'm already registered. I did that.
Oh, that's cool. That's a good first step. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. See you all.
Great. Thanks, everybody. Have a great rest of your day.
Thank you. We wish you the same.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.